Praise Jesus.
Woo!
Amen. We love you, Jesus. Save us.
Remember those walls that we call sin and shame.
Sin and shame. Them walls that He broke down for us. It's so great to know that I have a God that is big enough to knock down any wall that gets in my way, that gets me through any storm, anything that I need, my God provides for me, and He will you too. He will you too. No matter what storm you're going through today, no matter what you're going through, God will pull you through if you have faith and trust in Him. Faith and trust. Hello, my brothers and sisters in Christ. Welcome to today's message that God has put on my heart. And it is a message about fear. And there's two types of fear that we have to think about in our lives as humans. We have good fear, the fear that keeps us from getting hit by cars, the fear that keeps us from getting robbed, the fear that keeps us from doing, you know, typical normal human fear, the stuff that keeps us safe, that God gave us for a reason. But then there's the other fear that the devil likes to play with a lot. And that's the fear we're going to talk about today. The fear that the devil will put in your head. The fear that the devil will control you by. Open your Bibles up to Psalms 34, verse 4 through 8, I think. Yeah, 34, verses 4 through 8. Chapter 34, Psalms. I love Psalms. Man, it's my favorite book in the Bible. Psalms. All right. Starting at verse 4 in chapter 34. I prayed to the Lord and He answered me. He freed me from all my fears. Those who look to Him for help will be radiant with joy. No shadow of shame will darken their faces. In my desperation I prayed and the Lord listened. He saved me from all my troubles. For the angel of the Lord is a guard. He surrounds and defends all who fear Him. Taste and see that the Lord is good. Oh, the joys of those who take refuge in Him. Wow, what a beautiful few verses that was, man. The Lord is good. The Lord is great. The Lord is everything and anything you could think of in a positive light. God is that. There are certain types of fears in this world that we go through as human beings that we don't need to be fearful of. It causes anxiety, it causes nervousness, it causes problems mentally. And these are the fears that I'm talking about today. The fear of losing your job. The fear of maybe losing a loved one. The fear of losing your house. Those are the kind of fears that Satan will attack you with and make you do some wild things. I remember one time, this is a personal story about me. We were about to get kicked out of our house. And I used to take pills. You guys know that. I was an addict, a bad addict. I used to take them all the time. And I had a handful of them. But I sold every last one of the ones that the doctor gave me to get my addiction took care of. I sold those to keep from losing my house instead of keeping them. That's the kind of stuff Satan causes with fear. Overcoming fear, you must completely find the Lord and Savior Jesus Christ to overflow you with love and safety. And when you find Jesus Christ and you get saved and you get saved in His love and that overwhelming feeling, you will feel safe no matter what you're doing or where you're at. No matter what dark alley you're walking down, no matter what valley you're walking down, you will feel safe if you have Jesus Christ of Nazareth by your side. If you're driving in a nasty storm and it's kind of dangerous and you can't hardly see, you'll feel safe because Jesus is with you. I thought that the other day in the car. I was driving down the road and it was storming so bad that the windshield wipers wasn't even knocking the water off the windshield. And I was getting scared. I was like, should I pull over or what? So I thought about it for a minute. It kind of calmed down. But I thought, why did I get so scared? And that's a natural scare. That's not something that's sinful to be scared. You don't want to wreck and hurt nobody. But I started thinking, Jesus Christ is with me all the time. If I would have pulled the car over or if I would have kept going, Jesus Christ would have been with me. It wouldn't have mattered. Because I'm always safe when I have God's bubble around me. I'm always safe from insults. I'm always safe from danger. I'm always safe from Satan. And that's the truth. You cannot defeat fear or anything any other way. I don't care what doctors prescribe you what. I'm not saying medicine's bad. Medicine is good and it helps a lot of people. But there is nothing, nothing in this world that will take care of your fear like Jesus Christ. Nothing. He is the ultimate, ultimate pill for fear. The ultimate pill for fear is Jesus Christ. If you're scared of losing your home, or you're running out of money and you're scared you can't feed your kids, or you're addicted to something and you're scared you're going to overdose, seek Jesus Christ to take that fear away. I remember when I was an addict. I remember the fear I had of having to go through withdrawals. I remember that. I didn't have Jesus. I had Satan talking me into doing it again and again and again. And I'm lucky I'm alive. But I know now with Jesus Christ that I would be safe no matter what decision I made. The definition of fear is an intense emotion caused by the anticipation of danger or harm. It is a natural human response to perceived threats, whether they are real or imagined. There's different types of fear. That's fear that human beings have naturally. We have fears of losing stuff. We have fears of losing our kids, our loved ones. We have all kinds of different fears. We have fears of spiders and snakes. We have fears of certain water. Some people have fears of water. They don't want to be around water. Those are phobias. Those are fears. There's a difference between having fear of human beings and having respect of human beings. You should never, as a Christian, in your entire life, have fear of any man on this earth. For our God is almighty and bigger than any man walking the face of this earth today. I promise you. I don't care if he's the strongest, meanest UFC fighter in the world. Our God is bigger and better. But respect is different. I don't fear my boss. I don't fear him at all. He doesn't scare me, but I respect him. And I do what he tells me. Because I have respect for him. It's not because I'm scared of him or what the outcome will be. It's because I respect his decisions. The only thing in this world that we should fear is God himself. For God is a God that can be wrathful. And we should be fearful of his wrath. And if you're not fearful of God's wrath, I don't even want to go down that path today. Maybe someone uses fear of homelessness to make you a slave. Maybe you're living with someone that threatens to kick you out all the time. So you have to constantly slave for them, clean, mow their yard, do their dishes. Maybe that's your fear of being homeless. So you have to do things for human masters. That's no different than when the Egyptians captured the Israelites for 400 years and made them slaves. The person you're living with has treated you a way to make you fearful of homelessness. That means you become a master, a slave to a human master. And there's only one master that any human should follow, and that is Jesus Christ. He is the master of all masters, the king of all kings, the lord of all lords. Nobody should ever make you fearful for you losing your home. Nobody. That is Satan himself working through someone to scare you. That's different than being scared of getting hit by a car. That is fear of what are we going to do if we get kicked out? Oh my gosh, if she kicks us out or he kicks us out, what are we going to do? We'll have nowhere to go. We'll be sleeping in the streets. I have to do this. I have to do that. You don't have to. You just follow God's path. And I'm telling you that from the heart, from personal experience. Just follow God's path. He will lead you where you need to be. Don't be around people that make you that way. Don't be around people that make you fearful of them. We shall only fear God. Humans should never be feared. And there's multiple Bible verses that say that. There's multiple Bible verses. According to the Bible, God has given people the power to overcome fear. Some ways to do this includes pray about overcoming fear and ask God to cast out fear from your heart, mind, and soul. Read the Bible. Read, study, and meditate on the Word of God and memorize a verse that you can use to contradict lies you have been believing. Trust in God. Say, God, you know the struggle. You know I struggle with this fear, but I choose to trust you anyway. Replace fear with God's Word. Declare God's Word and use Scripture verses that emphasizes God's nature. Partner with prayer warriors. Me and my wife are prayer warriors together, like we are strong together in prayer. Find people that you trust and ask them to partner with you in prayer to overcome your fears. Your fears. There's multiple verses in the Bible of fearing humans. We should never fear any humans on this earth. There is not one man or woman walking the face of this earth that we should ever be scared of. Because Jesus Christ of Nazareth walked this earth himself and overcame everything, living, death. He trampled Satan and he rose. And if you have him in you, you have the same traits he has because he's with you in your heart. If you're a saved child of God, he is with you at all times. His bubble of protection is with you like Daniel in the lion's den. We should never fear stuff that we know God can protect us from. And human beings are one of them. There should never be a human being or a bully walking around trying to scare you or make you fearful in school or wherever you're at, even at work. Adults still bully adults. But if you have God with you, nobody can bully you. Because God won't allow it. One thing about God is he stands up for his children. And if you hurt one of his children, he can become very wrathful. And I wouldn't want to be in the person's shoes that's bullying one of God's children. I wouldn't. The Bible says humans shouldn't have human masters. I just talked about that. Overcome that fear with Christ. Know that if that person does kick you out, or if this human's bullying you, if you walk away from that situation, know that you're stepping out on faith and that Christ will lead you in a direction that you're supposed to go so you don't have to fear no more. Never fear when Christ is near. Never fear when Christ is near. Isn't that a beautiful rhyming word together? Never fear when Christ is near. If you have Christ in your heart, guess what? He's always near. I scream out here in this chapel. I know they can hear me in there, but I do not fear because Christ is near. I love it. I love having Jesus here. I know no matter what my situation is, whatever storm I'm going through, whatever valley I'm marching through, I will get to the mountaintop and I won't fear at all. I won't fear at all. Though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. I know for a fact that waiting around every corner of this building that I'm in, everywhere you look, Satan is waiting for me to open a door for him to enter so he can start attacking me with fear, anxiety, anger, addiction again, or whatever he wants to. And I know he's right here, here, here. He's everywhere trying to get up here because he can never get here. He can never get where Christ is at. He can never be Christ. And all I do is I'll either hit my knees and pray before my message and say, keep Satan away from me at all times, or I'll hold my cross up and say, Satan, you have no chance. Away with you. Satan is what causes the kind of fear I'm talking about. No human on this earth is worth fearing. That is Satan. Satan telling you to. That is Satan making you fear. Satan uses fear of people losing jobs, losing homes, but especially the number one thing that the human being is scared of is death. As a human, your natural instinct, your fleshly instinct is to survive. But I'm telling you, my brothers and sisters, and I'm telling you this, listen closely. When you find Jesus Christ, that fear of death disappears. Because when you find Jesus Christ, you know for a without a shadow of a doubt that you will never die. You will never die. Jesus Christ will meet you at the doorway of heaven, and you will never have to experience the sting of death. Fear is Satan's number one way to control you, to make you live in anxiety, nervousness, being scared. Fear leads into sin with drinking, depression, drugs, and sex. Most people that are loaded down with fear, they end up becoming addicts. They end up drinking to try to take that fear away or try to fill in that hole that Jesus could fill in. And I know there's people out there lost right now listening to me that's probably drinking or having sex all the time with random people just to try to make you feel better, to fill that hole in your heart. But I'm telling you, there is only one that can fill that hole in your heart. One. And that is Jesus Christ. Nobody, no human, no earthly thing in this world can fill that hole in your heart. So I made this little board of the human being and all the fears we have. Snakes, spiders, addiction, home, family, job, death, everything we just discussed. And I started thinking. God's name is spelled G-O-D. And I started realizing the reason why he has the O in the middle of his name. The O is your bubble of protection. All these fears that Satan's controlling you with, all these fears, that bubble that God puts around you keeps all that stuff out. All those things that Satan tries to attack you with in fear, God's bubble keeps them away. Every since I've been devoted to God, every since my whole life is about Jesus Christ, I have yet to feel fear that Satan tries to get me to feel. I feel fear about maybe if my wife hasn't called me and she's been gone for hours and stuff like that. But I don't fear nothing on this earth. I don't fear the stuff Satan wants me to. I don't fear the things that Satan puts in my head. Because my Jesus is stronger than him and has already trampled him. And that's the truth. If you don't know Jesus Christ, I am telling you, if you want that fear gone, there is no pill that will take it away. There's only one that will take it away. And that is Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Repent. Ask for forgiveness. Allow Jesus in your heart sincerely. You have to mean it from the bottom of your heart. And he will take every fear that's in your body and release it. And then God's bubble of protection will be around you. And no matter what bullies do, no matter what insults do, no matter what Satan does, it can't touch you. He loves us. And all he wants to do is protect us. We're his children. We're his children. Praise God. We're his children. I love it. I love him. Thank you, Jesus, for protecting me and leading me down the path of righteousness. Praise His name. Praise His name.